Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Shaving with Rich. I'm excited about this shave today because I am going to be shaving with some stuff that I haven't used for a little while, stuff that I've always enjoyed but I just haven't reached for. Recently, I'm going to be shaving with some new soap that's relatively new to me that I've been excited about, wanted to dive deeper into. For just sake of trying out the soap and getting more familiar with it. So this week in the Rich Man Shaving group on Facebook, it's Gillette Nasset week. So this will be my first shave of the week here using a Gillette Nasset. It'll be a great week because I'll be able to put them and try them in different razors and things of the sort. So I actually will show you the razor that I picked out, and like I had mentioned, it's one that I haven't reached for a while, and that happens sometimes even with some of my best razors. Anyways, that's this razor right here. As you can see, it's a nice beautiful razor. This is the Bronze Timeless safety bar. And we just pull this out, set down. I like this razor. I took the blade out of it, so I can handle it and don't worry. But anyways, I enjoy the weight and the feel of this razor. It is on the hefty side for sure. I love the scallop top, and it looks like this is actually starting to patina and look more natural and aging, just sitting on my shelf. Let me take this bottom plate off since we're going to be loading a blade anyways. But on the bottom here, you know, it says bronze and it's got their stamp here engraved for timeless, and then it says 0.38 as well right here in the bottom. So that's the blade gap, 0.38, which sounds very mild, but the geometry, there's a lot more geometry that goes into a razor than just the blade gap. So let me go ahead and take this out and grab this Gillette Nasset from the package and make sure that I don't cut myself right here. That's usually when you get cut, is when you get so confident and what you're doing that, you know, you start, you know, driving on cruise control, you know, and before you know it, it just takes a little lapse for a moment before you know you're cut. That can happen with a DE razor, a straight razor, or, you know, anything shaving related. I've seen it 100 times, as Chris Farley said years ago. All right, guys, so the blade is now loaded. Let me sit that in my holder here. Break out the soap here. This is the Pouty Face Tim Soap by 345 Soaps. That's right here, 345 Soap Company. I'm going to leave a link to the website here for 345 Soap Company in the description below. You can click the link. John's a great guy in the Rich Man Shaving group, and you know, it's awesome. He was very instrumental in helping make this happen, which is just fun for the Rich Man Shaving group. And I was planning on buying one of his soaps anyways to try out, so it worked out. So anyways, I have so many soaps and stuff that I can't get around to all of them, but this one I don't want to just let sit on the shelf. So I've already done the liberty of loading it up because I was kind of playing around before, because it's, you know, like I said, it is a new base to me, so I'm getting a little bit more familiar with it. But the scent on this is really nice. The soap's not available anymore, but this is like a tropical citrus coconut smell. It's right down my alley. I enjoy it. So let me set this aside over here And I may come back to, depending on how it goes, but this shave is going to be different than the typical videos I've done lately. Let me just get a little mist. You got a spray right here, like the Scented Soldier shaves. Tim Delaney, thanks. I'm sure a lot of us, people, I'm sure it's not the first time that somebody picked up the, spray bottle, but it's become more recognized and popular since you tried it, and it just sprays a nice little mist on your face. Actually, you know what? It feels really good too. I actually use this sometimes when I'm turning brushes. But anyways, you know what? I better. This brush has been sitting here for a little bit. I'm gonna actually get it moist. Maybe I should have done this norm like I normally do it, but I was having fun playing around with this soap just a little bit, before this. I don't know, maybe it was like an hour ago. Went into the other room and then I to grab something. I probably got sidetracked and then start my shave a little bit. See, my first tendency is go right back to the water and dip it, but I just like that misty feel. I maybe might maybe I'll start doing that more often. We'll see. It's kind of nice, especially in the warm months. So if I wanted, I could just use this right now, it'd be ready. I'm sure that's plenty protective. Or I can just keep messing around with the soap, you know what I mean? So why not? I'll just I don't want to overdo the video. I know my last video was kind of long because I had this message that I want to share, a patriotic message. I try and do one of those every year around the 4th of July, but I was like under the weather. This feels really good. It smells really good. And it feels like this is going to be cushiony because of like the density of the soap. You know what? It's not the usual lather, and I'm sure I could make a real voluptuous bearded lather if I wanted to. For sake of time, I'm curious. I think what I'm gonna do is just keep it slick. And why not? Let's just do that. I'm going crazy with the spray bottle on this shave. All right. Most important thing, just enjoy your shaves. This CDB, Christopher David Bailey. A lot of people like to call him CBD. We had fun with that in our group a while back. We're going back and forth between Tim and
One, two, three into the four. Snoop Doggy Dogg and Dr. Dre is at the door, ready to make an entrance. So back on up, cause you know about to rip this. Give me the microphone first so I can bust like a bubble. Compton and Long Beach together, now you know.
Like said that they wanted a soap, and so you know, they made it happen. So, anyways, first a shave with a Gillette Nasset blade in this safety bar razor. 0.38 on the blade gap, like I mentioned. Now this is, to me, isn't gonna feel like what you would expect. 0.38 sounds like almost nothing. There's more efficiency to it than this. Definitely for me, it feels comfortable. I do have a, some little spots here on my face, a little pimple or is it or whatever. So that is something that sometimes can get cut in a shave, but so far I don't notice anything like that happening. And this Gillette Nasset blade is really making a nice comfortable experience. I don't feel any resistance, nice and smooth. It doesn't feel too aggressive. I'm just kind of telling you what my experience is as it's happening. And hopefully it helps you. So, one of the great things about wet shaving is I think I might have caught my nose.
Good one, Rich. Just talking about speeding tickets. There you go. Just
whipping it around, like I said, you get comfortable. I don't even think it'll show, but feels like there might be something there without blood. That's just because I'm talking and doing all this stuff. Seems like there's a tendency when people get cut, it's usually a speeding ticket. What I call them, or have termed them for a long time. Or just not paying attention. You get really comfortable. That's why, you know, like cruise control, you know, you first start driving a car, you're very careful. Make sure you hit that blinker just at the right time and make sure you come to a complete stop. And then you've been doing it for a while, you get a little more comfortable, a little easier on the brake, a little quicker to start off, going a few miles over the speed limit, you know, chatting it up with your friends instead before you're just like 2 and 10, 2 and 10, 2 and 10, you know what I mean? So that's what happened. See? I think that's, yeah, there's a little underneath that, there's like a blemish, and I just went over the blemish. What happens. So clearly there's enough efficiency in this razor to get the job done. One thing I noticed too about weepers, anything that bleeds on video tends to look worse than it actually is. Just saying. Comment below if you're a content creator, you're watching this, and you would agree with that. That, like, you've made videos, and when you, like, get a little tiny thing, see? And it just shows up on camera, like, you're bleeding worse than it actually is. Like all those micro weepers. Sometimes it's just the price I pay for a super close shave, like a BBS shave. Which I'm totally fine with. Alright, so, I really have an itch to just make this awesome lather, because you guys know how I like to just put lather on my hands and all that. Should I do that? Is it too late to do it? We're 13 minutes in the video. You know what? We're not going to do that. We're just going to keep going, because the lather is good and protective. I'm trying to keep the, I decided on this shave, but like, you know what, Rich? Let's keep the shave, the video time on this. Let's just keep it down. You know, that meaning like not 30 minutes. Let's just have fun. There's no song or music in this shave. Just kind of kicking it with you guys, talking more about, you know, the shave product and my experiences I'm shaving with them. So I really want to get let me just spray that here. I may just have to follow this up with a shave with a bowl lather. Or maybe, you know what, in this video, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to bowl lather, I'll speed it up, and just to satisfy my itch to see the bowl lather, and to satisfy you guys if you're like, think that, yeah, that's a little bit light on his face or whatever, you'll see what this soap is capable of doing. And I like to switch it up. It's really hard to kind of to continue to learn and evolve your game. If things are done exactly the same way every time, you don't ever venture outside of those lines to see, you know, because when I first started, I wanted a huge voluminous beard almost, because, you know, it was enjoyable for me. When it actually comes down to the shave itself, like whether you have a thin layer, but it's cushiony, it's good, or if you have this much lather. This much lather is not, a lot of that is just going to be wasted lather. But, you know, if it's for your enjoyment, then that part's definitely not wasted. But as far as just for a shave itself, you know, how much lather do you really need? That's a good question. So let's go across the grain here. Yeah, it does look like I caught myself. I can feel it. You probably, you can't really see it. And that's just because I was not paying attention. Could be like, oh yeah, it's good. I'm comfortable with it. Just like I was, kind of the example I was given before. It's 0.38, so it just seems like, oh yeah, it'd be impossible to nick yourself with something like this. Well, I just proved that it's still possible. But I'm still very comfortable to shave with it, you know, quite fast. You know, when I pull out some more aggressive razors, I don't whip it around like a samurai sword. I shouldn't use that term for this razor. It's been dubbed already, rightly so, for the carbon. That razor is incredible. I wanted to use that again today as it's new, and I got a lot of questions about it. I want to compare different blades in it. You know, you get a brand new car, you kind of want to drive it a little bit more. If I'm Jay Leno and I got, you know, 100 cars, I don't know how many cars he has, but I'm sure his new cars he wants to drive a little bit more, right? Than the one, who knows? I don't know how he does that, but he's got an awesome car collection. Comment below if you'd like to have a car collection like Jay Leno. Alright. I'm still gonna do the lather mittens. Just from whatever I can pull in the brush, which may not be. We'll see how much I can pull out of the brush. All right, good. Good enough, we're gonna do. Pull the lather out of the water in there. Good enough. I was just talking to my buddy today about the 80s, growing up as a kid in the 80s, and how awesome it was. See, there's more than enough here to keep that. How awesome it was to grow up as a kid in the 80s. I couldn't disagree, it was awesome. We'll never, ever get to go back to those times again. This world that will never, you know, be able to relive that era again. It's just changed. It's not the same world anymore. Yeah, that's nice. I am a huge fan of the Lathermans. Lathermans actually originated when I got the Rockwell 6S back in the day. And it had the matte finish. And there was a little bit less slick on my face than my other favorite razor at the time, which is still one of my favorites, the Mercury Future. It's copper. Not copper, it's chrome. So I just compensated by adding more lather to my hand and keeping it in my hand so I could do all that stuff. And I called it Lather Mittens, and since then, it's been Lather Mittens, and I've loved it ever since. So, I'm really enjoying this razor. I don't shave with it enough. I'm gonna mist a little bit more. Super great shave. I always go like I push BBS actually while I'm in the shave. A lot of people advise against that, and I don't disagree with it. Especially if you have like more sensitive skin or whatever. But as you shave, you're gonna get more familiar and get your own routine of what's great for you. Important thing is to find out what works good for you. What works good for you may not be the same as what works good for somebody else. So it's very subjective. But you just stick with it. If you're not getting the best shaves of your life, come to the Rich Man Shaving Group and ask away. I promise you, with as many active members that we have, it doesn't matter what time of the night, somewhere in the world, there's always somebody in the group that's active at that time, whether they're, I live across the pond over in Europe or Australia or Singapore, wherever. There's always somebody. Man, that's just good. I enjoy that. There's always somebody that will answer your questions, and you may get 10, 15, 20 responses on a single question that you put out there. Yeah, a lot of people are surprised. Jeez. This is stuff that would all close up a few minutes after my shave, but I just have this tendency. It's like an itch. I just love to... I love that feeling after a shave when you put all the products on, post-shave, everything's closed up, you touch your face, and it just feels like a baby's butt, like, so soft. My wife, she loves it too. So she touched my face, she's like, oh, you shaved them. I guess I did. So maybe that's why I always push for Ultra BBS. All the time. I love it. I love it. And if I can get away with it, I'm definitely gonna do it. All right, let me dry my face. We're gonna put on some aftershave. So 1 second. All right. Shake this up. Now, when I ordered this, I could order it with or without alcohol. For me, I like alcohol. No, just kidding. I do like alcohol my aftershaves. So why not? Let's just do it. Shake a good amount in my hand, because, you know, these are the things you just go lavishly about in your life. Get a little bit on my nose. A, so I can smell it, and B, because I got that tiny little, you almost can't even see it, but that was a reminder, like, easy on the pedal, Rich. Pay attention to the wheel, so to speak. It's just great, man. Love that. You know what else I'm going to do? I'm going to do this just for the lavish sake of it, you know? This is actually something that I think is, like, affordable. An affordable way to pamper yourself. Shaving. Think about it. All the things, there's things so much more. But two squirts, that's what I always do, is two squirts from A&E. Post-shave serum, it's incredible. I'll just continue to use this stuff. Maybe I should, in my next order, throw another one or two of them in there just to have them sitting here, because I'll probably be using this stuff for a long time. It's so good. All right, cool. All right, guys. Well, thank you so much for watching this episode, hanging out with me, and I'll see you in the next episode of Shaving with Rich. We'll see you very soon. Take care.
Oh, no, not my Rich Man brush. No.
Rich Man Shaving on Etsy. Check the link below.